a key determinant of how well you recover from vasculitis, as we said in one of the earlier segments, is exercise. Because vasculitis is injury to the is leads to injury to blood vessels, and that is what causes symptoms. How quickly and how well these vessels heal and regenerate has a direct relationship with how soon can a patient get back to exercising. Of course, there are some forms of vasculitis, such as diseases like GPA with mononeuritis multiplex, which impacts nerves, where that's a little bit harder because you cannot feel or you may have lost strength. But even there, just as it is true of stroke patients, patients with other forms of nerve injury due to blood flow abnormalities, really how quickly you can get back even into light, regular activity is really key. So there are a lot of initial studies which do suggest that there are certain dietary changes which can help with inflammation in general. We are often asked to comment on the use of anti-inflammatory diets or the use of turmeric and other spices to try to help control systemic inflammation. So while the initial studies for these things are encouraging in the lab and in test tubes and in cell cultures, we unfortunately lack still really good, robust clinical data looking at large numbers of people who have actually tried to test how well these changes and these modifications work, particularly in vasculitis. That being said, we do encourage everyone, you know, to come with your questions and to ask us, and we will always do our best to have a personalized individual discussion with you based on your preferences about what might work and certainly what is not harmful to try. Regardless, one thing we should emphasize is that while diet and exercise and lifestyle changes are helpful, and do have a very real impact on how well someone recovers long-term from vasculitis, they are not a substitute, unfortunately, at this point for medicines and for following up with regular testing to be sure that we are controlling your disease.